Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about how the Dodge Demon manages such an impressive launch, but we're not really going to just focus on the tires or the engine. We're going to talk about two of the different systems they employ, the Transbrake and Torque Reserve, both of these basically first for a production vehicle. And so first, let's just work through our system here. Here we have our car starting with the intake leading to our wheels. Up front is more of the Torque Reserve system, and then towards the back, once you get to the transmission, we get into the Transbrake. So let's just work our way through this flow. You have your air filter that travels through, you're gonna pull in that air through a 2.7 liter supercharger. The Hellcat has a 2.38 liter supercharger at 0.8 bar, so this is a 25% increase in boost, 14.5 PSI, sending that air into the intercooler, then to the throttle, then in your 6.2 liter V8 engine, 840 horsepower, 770 pound-feet of torque if you're running 100 octane fuel. And so, Torque Reserve is going to occur basically right here, where you're going to pre-fill after the supercharger but before the throttle with 8 PSI of boost and hold your engine RPM between 950 and 2350 RPM, 2350 being the stall speed for the torque converter. So, what's going on right here? The supercharger actually doesn't have a clutch disconnect, so it's always spinning depending on the engine RPM. And basically, if you don't need boost, let's say you're at half throttle or partial throttle, whatever it may be, you have a bypass valve that allows that boost to recirculate back to the intake, back inside the supercharger. And so what you're doing at a launch, let's say you pull up to the drag strip, you're waiting to launch, you put it in this torque reserve mode where you can build up the revs here and build up this boost. It closes off this bypass valve so that you don't recirculate that air, and then it uses the fuel flow and the spark timing. It retards that timing enough where you can hold the engine RPM between 950 and 2350 while still maintaining and holding 8 PSI boost, you know, from the intercooler onward. So you've got that boost ready to throw down as soon as you're ready to launch. And then we get into our Transbrake system. So this is interesting because when you're sitting there at the drag strip and you're about to launch, if you have it in this Transbrake mode, your foot's not actually on the brake. The transmission is actually what's holding it. So your foot's already off the brake and you're just using a paddle shifter to tell it to go, and you're modulating your throttle to hold the throttle between 950 and 2350. As mentioned, if you get outside of this range, it'll take you out of torque reserve. You can still launch, but you won't have the benefits of torque reserve. So then you have your 8-speed automatic transmission where that torque's going to. And in this Transbrake mode, what you do, you have three clutches basically for every gear. And in order to use any one gear, you're going to be using three clutches. This is certainly a simplified drawing, but basically you're going to hold all three clutches necessary to be in first gear, and then you're going to hold one clutch for second gear. And because you've got two gears held, you can't accelerate because those fight against each other. And so it holds all of that engine torque and prevents the rear from spinning because the transmission is in two gears at the same time. Now, if you're familiar with Transbrakes, you may say, you know, traditionally they tend to use, or often they do use, first and reverse gear rather than first and second gear. I asked Dodge, why did they do first and second? They said it's for safety reasons, which makes a ton of sense. So let's just say hypothetically something were to fail. If you had it in first and reverse, you don't want the car flying backwards when everyone is assuming that if you're about to launch, it's going to go forwards. So in the, you know, unlikely scenario that the transmission were to fail, you're going to have that car no matter what. The only direction it can go is forwards. So that's basically built-in safety, why they do first in second, but is of course sized and built appropriately to be able to handle that torque and be able to hold the vehicle in place. So when you put it in this drag mode, it is pretty cool. All you're basically doing, you're holding on to one paddle and paddle shifter, and you've got your foot on the throttle holding it at a set RPM. Whatever RPM you deem between 950 and 2350 will give you, you know, maximum power, but also not spin up the tires. And so in that mode, you're going to basically release. Once you get the Christmas tree coming down, you're going to release your paddle shifter. and as soon as you release that, it's immediately sending torque to the rear wheels. So it's pretty cool. You release the paddle, your foot's not on the brake, so you don't have that time that you're removing from the brake pressure. It's just basically instantaneous, and then you're flying down the drag strip. You ease into the throttle, of course, because you're holding it at a set RPM, so you release that pedal, you release that paddle, and then you ease into the throttle and continue to fly down, and then it starts to shift through the gears. But all it's basically doing when you release that paddle is releasing this single clutch that's holding the transmission in place so that you can't rotate the rear axle. So what does all of this add up to? Well, Dodge claims that with the Transbrake and Torque Reserve active, you get up to 120% more engine torque than if you didn't have Torque Reserve. The Transbrake also preloads the driveline with torque, which leads to full engine delivery of that torque from the engine to the wheels in just 150 milliseconds. So really fast, and that enables you to get a quicker 0-60 time and also a quicker quarter mile time. So very impressive technology. If you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching.